Now I don't. Welcome to Video Guys Live. November is NDI November. We're using the first 2 weeks of November and we are doing nothing but featuring NDI, NDI workflows. NDI is the IP video solution that was introduced by New Tech 4 years ago that has revolutionized the world of live video production. Want to review some of the shows we've done already on this program and what's coming up. We kicked it all off with Dr. Cross, the chief technology guy at New Tech, who basically invented NDI and gave it to the world with his engineers, and that was a great interview. We really talked about all the ins, outs, ups, downs, history, and future of NDI. Definitely want to watch that. Last week on Tuesday, we had Dan Mile from Bird Dog. We brought him in from Australia live, and it was a great show. We talked about their product line, their approach to NDI, using their own custom silicone, their own custom hardware in order to do the NDI decode and encoding. Then on Wednesday, we had, we had Panasonic on. We had Raj from Panasonic on. Thursday was Shane from Telestream. And then today, this week, we're kicking off with George from Epiphan to talk about the Pearl 2 and its NDI implication. Tomorrow, we're going to have Will Waters from New Tech talking about their products and how they relate to the history of NDI and where they're going. And then on Thursday, we're going to have Paul Richards. He's going to be on from PTZ Optics, and he's going to be kicking off and pulling out our Huddle Cam giveaway. That's right, we are giving away a Huddle Cam Pro, a Pro NDI webcam, a $499 value we'll be giving away tomorrow. Today's show, I'm really excited. We have George Herbert from Epiphan. He's going to tell us all about their Pearl 2 and how it relates to NDI. So if we can bring him up, let's get the show started. Hey, George, how are you?
Hey, Gary, how are you?
I am doing great. We're going to do this show today. We're going to be talking about the Pearl 2. I have one over here on the side that I'll pick up while you're talking about it. But first of all, I want you to just tell us about, before we get to the NDI features, give us a quick overview of what the Pearl 2 is, what it does, and how it works.
Yeah, so the idea with the Pearl 2 is to provide a dedicated standalone hardware appliance for all of your sort of production needs. You know, so the idea is to take where you might traditionally have a whole rack of gear like scalers and switchers and streamers and recorders and try to condense that down into a single piece of hardware that does it all in one, a dedicated piece of kit. So you can see it has multiple video inputs on it, up to six in full HD, has multiple audio inputs. It can create multiple encoded outputs for streaming and recording. It can do mixing, switching, scaling, all of it kind of built in. It has that cool touchscreen on the front of it for a lot of the basic controls, but it's also a network-based device, so you could really do it from anywhere, including outside of your network with the right setup. So it's a great cornerstone that someone might install in their studio or in that case, that model, take it on the road with them. It's small enough and we ship it in a hard rugged case even. So it's a great piece of kit.
Now, you guys added NDI back in March 2019. Now, I've been a big proponent of NDI. You know, I actually heard about NDI from Dr. Cross before it was called NDI, before we even knew what it was. I didn't even realize what he was telling me about, and he had it fully cooked. And then that IBC show, he introduced it to the world. But from the very get-go, I was very vocal with you guys and your engineers and your ownership saying, you know, get NDI into your products. And the Pearl 2, you were able to do it with. And I understand some of the other products you'd like to, but there's just not enough horsepower in there. But talk about the whole genesis of how you got NDI into the Pearl 2.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, it was an exciting technology from the beginning, and we were certainly keeping an eye on it and looking how the market was changing and how people were adopting it and using it. And around the same time that we decided to pull the trigger and add it as a feature set to the Pearl 2, which of course was available to any pre-existing owners through a simple firmware update. It was around the same time we saw a huge uptick in other manufacturers, like camera manufacturers, implementing it built into their cameras. So it really changed the ecosystem, and so it only made sense to go along with that.
And you guys, one of the things before we get into the NDI features of the Pearl 2, I think something that's very important is you guys took not only a firmware approach to adding NDI, you took a firmware approach to adding 4K. So if you have a Pearl 2, you don't have to pay for 4K if you don't need it, but if you want 4K, it's ready to go. You just have to pay for that firmware upgrade.
Exactly. It is an optional add-on. And quite honestly, I would say the vast majority of people are not quite ready for a full 4K workflow yet. It's coming, but bandwidth isn't free, so it's sometimes a bit of a barrier. But we do. We have that add-on for the Pearl 2, where you can add the 4K support. That would give you 4K HDMI, 12G 4K SDI inputs, support for 4K over NDI, and of course 4K streaming and recording. So for some people, it really fits exactly what they need and opens up a lot of possibilities.
4K is funny. We've had 4K cameras and 4K glass before we even had 4K. The problem is 4K pipes are expensive, and even with NDI, you still need horsepower to handle 4K. So like your box is a great box, but this is a mini little box. If we can cut back to it just to show the relative size of it. And I'm going to put a water bottle next to it just so you can see the scale of this thing, guys. This is just a little water bottle. So it's a small unit and it doesn't have a ton of horsepower in there, and that's not a knock on the product. It's just limited. So there's only so much 4K it can do. So you can really only get one 4K in and out. And that's really not a limitation of I/O. It's just a limitation of the pure processing power in the box, correct?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's not an unlimited amount of processing power there, like anything else. And so, yeah, sometimes there's some trade-offs to make there to get things exactly where you want in that sweet spot. And again, a lot of people are not ready for a full 4K workflow yet. And if they can use it just as full HD and be able to do a lot more from a multitasking perspective. You're right. It's funny. We talk about how on the surface, 4K is four times that of full HD, which on paper sounds really cool. But it all goes hand in hand. It means you need four times the processing power as well. So it's not an easy task. You really have to look
So
at that.
let's talk about the NDI capabilities of the Pearl. The Pearl has four inputs under HD, and all four of those can be NDI, or you can mix and match NDI and SDR HDMI, correct?
Exactly. Yeah. So if we're dealing with only direct video inputs, HDMI and SDI, we could do as many as six. NDI does take up a little bit more processing power than, say, a direct captured connection. So there we usually recommend up to four NDI inputs. But yes, we could be mixing and matching those with some direct inputs, or even other streamed inputs other than NDI. If we are going to 4K, again, just because of the overhead and the workload, we do have to knock that down a little bit. But again, there's still a lot of great ways we can leverage it.
Cool. So one of the things that I really wanted to focus on this show wasn't the specs of the Pearl 2. People can get the specs and the pricing on our website of the Pearl 2, the Pearl 2 Rack, or the Pearl 2 Twin. What I really wanted to talk about was NDI and some of those NDI workflows. So the first workflow we want to talk about is you can use multiple Pearl 2s and they can all be linked together via NDI. Talk to that. We've got colleges and universities, or maybe some churches that have a main room and an overflow room, or government agencies where maybe they have a board room, but they also have another room where maybe they do their public meetings in, their non-public meetings in, and they want to be able to talk. So go over how people are using multiple Pearl 2s linked via NDI within the same network.
Yeah, well, exactly like you said, sometimes it's multiple Pearl 2s, or sometimes it's bridging ecosystems. When we put NDI into the Pearl 2, we wanted to make sure we packed as much of NDI as we could into it. So from an input perspective, we can bring in full NDI or NDI HX inputs, and Pearl 2 can also output full NDI. So this means that one Pearl 2 could feed full NDI to another Pearl 2 or another workflow into maybe an NDI monitor or something in a breakout room. And this just gives us a ton of flexibility. And so we have seen people kind of create these multi-room studio setups where Pearl 2s are talking to each other across the network and just passing NDI back and forth depending on what rooms they need and what sort of scale they need for their production, which has been really fun.
So I could have two or three PTZ cameras in a room, and then like I have here, a laptop coming in via the network or across NDI into a Pearl, and I could have, let's say, three rooms within my facility who have that. And any room not only has access to the cameras in the room, but all the other cameras or the program output of that Pearl too, correct?
Yeah, exactly.
So that's a level of scaling that gets really fun. And where it really becomes cool is, I know we've got some folks who have TriCasters as the heart of their whole solution. And they want to have like another room that's like a mini studio or an offshoot room, or my example, like a boardroom. Maybe I'm a school system and I have a TriCaster set up in my TV production studio. I could put a Pearl 2 on the network, let's say in the boardroom, and I could have a couple of PTZ cameras in the boardroom now feeding into the TriCaster through the Pearl. And that opens up a whole level of productivity and feature sets that to me is really fantastic, because I love the Pearl from a pure able to switch and stream. But, you know, I also love the cool things like lower thirds and graphics and stuff that you could do with a TriCaster. You can marry them together, or it doesn't have to be a TriCaster. It could be a vMix or a Wirecast Gear. But my example is that a Pearl 2 can become a whole satellite studio to an existing mixing installation that's also NDI.
No, absolutely. And, you know, one of the differences here at Epiphan, one of the things that's a little different in our products from some of those names you've mentioned, like the TriCasters or the vMixes or the Wirecasts, a lot of their products are geared very much towards the very traditional broadcast style operator. And so for people at more of the entry level or in the middle, they're a bit complex. And we've tried to make sure that Pearl 2 kind of ease of use wise fits a little lower there, so that you could have a satellite office with a less experienced operator get it set up and just send that feed out to maybe the larger broadcast system. Absolutely.
Yeah, I think one of the things that's important to talk about here, and you hit on it, is that there's different levels of complexity and power of these products. And one of the things we really love about the Epiphan Pearl and the Pearl Mini is that they're really kind of set it and forget it products. So if you take the time to set it up, your talent, i.e. me, the person, the show, or the teacher, or the preacher, can actually operate a Pearl 2 or a Pearl Mini themselves very easily through the touchpad in the front for presets they can go to. It's very easy to set up your streams with. So having nothing to do with NDI, there's an ease of use level that the Pearl really comes in handy, especially if you're trying to integrate the Pearl into more of an AV than a pro video environment, but you still want NDI, you still want to stream, you still want those other values. So the Pearl 2 as a standalone product is incredible. Add NDI and it's even better. But we're going to add another piece of secret sauce, George. Let's talk about SRT and what that opens up. And before we do that, why don't you explain to our folks here, and we've had some shows on it, I think with you, in fact, let's explain in a minute or two what SRT is and why it's so cool.
So SRT is a streaming protocol that was created by Hivision. It's technically open source, and there's a huge number of companies that participate in what is known as the SRT Alliance, which means they work together to help build an ecosystem. SRT stands for Secure Reliable Transport. The idea being to create a streaming protocol that can function as a point-to-point backbone that is very low latency, high quality, secure with encryption, and is easy to traverse various complex networks, firewalls, and so on. And it actually delivers all of those things. It's a fantastic piece. You know, we were talking about maybe from one studio room to another within the same network from an NDI perspective. Well, what SRT can give us is that same kind of concept, except across the world. NDI is really a local network technology.
Yeah.
SRT in a lot of ways offers somewhat similar competitive things, but from an outside the network, from a global perspective, not bound to the local network, where you can make sure it's secure and you can make sure that it's very low latency, all things considered, compared to more traditional streaming technologies. And it's actually opened up a ton of possibilities. It's what we've been doing here at Epiphan for our own content creation for the past almost 8 months, I guess now, since a lot of us have been working from home, you know, myself included. I have a Pearl Mini here in my home where I have all of my audio and camera gear connected to it. And when I need to participate in our webinars or our live shows, or even joining some others, I can send an SRT stream from my home, from my Pearl, to a Pearl 2 in our main studio, and the producer can do all the work. I just literally have to stand here and stare at the camera, and everything else is being taken care of. I don't really have to do anything on my end. So a Pearl 2 can become a great studio hub. You could feed in from outside. You could use NDI in parallel to that to bring in other stuff. We use it a lot for lower thirds and other software applications. since we support Alpha Channel over NDI. So there's a lot of ways of kind of bridging and layering all these different technologies to bring it all together.
Yeah, George, one of the things about SRT that I want to stress to people is just like NDI, it's not just the video signal going from one place to the other. It's all those control abilities and everything else. So we did a SRT demonstration with the guys at Bird Dog with some of their cameras. And we had a guy in Dallas, we had me, this was during the epidemic. So I was actually in my office on a webcam. And then we had the guys in Australia, and we were actually cutting and controlling each other's cameras and stuff like that. So it's really, really cool. So SRT kind of lets you, NDI is local. SRT lets you have like multiple nodes of NDI that are connected together, but you still get that same two-way connectivity, and the latency, just like NDI, is really low. So it's really the next best thing to being there. I think SRT and NDI is the combination that's really going to allow cloud-based remote production to really take on a whole nother level. And, you know, one of the things I've been talking about all on these shows and for months is that the people using the equipment we sell, I feel, are producing content that looks and sounds and is as good as the stuff we're seeing on the networks. And the reason is because we've actually been figuring out these technologies ourselves as they've been coming out. The networks had to say, oh my God, the world's gone crazy. We have coronavirus. We can't go into studios. We can't do this stuff. The show must go on. Well, we've been doing shows like this for, I dare say, years, but certainly going back to 2019, we had workflows or remote workflows with NDI and SRT. We've been dabbling with it since February, March. By coincidence, it wasn't, SRT didn't come because of the virus shutting everything down. It was going to be, I thought, one of the biggest stories at NAB this year. Only we didn't have an NAB this year. And I think you were on a show we did in March when we were talking about that.
No, exactly. And you know, it's funny, a silver lining to all of this COVID stuff, if there is one, is the fact that we have seen a lot of this AV tech like NDI and SRT and the way people are using it very creatively. They pre-existed, like you said, but their adoption rates have probably gone from what would have taken a couple of years to 5 months. And it's incredible seeing what people are able to do with it. And there's still a lot more room to grow. Like you said, some of the more traditional networks really need to get on board, because I've seen some of the stuff they create and it's not great. Whereas if they could use even simple technologies like...
You are being kind SRT, by calling it not great. I'm going to be honest and say a lot of this stuff looks like crap. It's pixelated, it's fuzzy, there's no audio sync, and it's embarrassing. But the show must go on, and we know how to do it better because we've been doing it better. Now, one of the things I want to jump a little to now is let's talk about the future a little bit, because... Well, before we get to the future, I want to talk about something that I guess I kind of skipped over, and that is with SRT and NDI, I said Pearls on the previous slide, not Pearl 2, because as you mentioned, a Pearl Mini could be something great to bring in remotely from a remote location. You send the Pearl Mini to someone in California, you're producing your show in New York, and you got someone in Texas. That Pearl Mini, once it comes in via SRT, now becomes an NDI source through the Pearl, for the Pearl itself or for other things hooked up to the Pearl too. So that's very cool also, because let's say I have a mixer that's like a Roland mixer or someone else's mixer that doesn't have electronics in it like that, doesn't have SRT or NDI, I can use a Pearl's SRT coming into Pearl 2, integrating with that bigger, more elaborate mixer to now bring SRT and NDI into what was an older fashioned mixing environment, kind of like a Roland mixer or something, or a data video as an example.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, these technologies, they're fantastic at helping bridge a lot of these different pieces, and it's great to interconnect. And again, that's one of the advantages of both SRT and NDI, is that the range of companies out there supporting these technologies, and you named them off the top, whether it's the guys at Bird Dog who are awesome, we've done some work with them as well, whether it's the guys at PTZ Optics or Panasonic or whoever it is, just, you know, the interoperability between all these different products makes it so easy to deliver some amazing, amazing content.
Cool. So now I want to talk about the future. And when I kick off my future shows almost with every guest, I've said, you know, the future is kind of now. Dr. Cross said it best. He said, we just skipped 5 years in this technology where he thought we'd be as far as using and delivering. We are 5 years ahead of the curve now, but that's where we are now. So everything else has been accelerated as well. Another company that got accelerated 5 years ahead was this company called Zoom. And with Zoom, Microsoft Teams and Google, they have to compete, and WebEx, they're all there. So when I talk about the future, with companies about NDI, the first thing I talk about is how are you going to have your products better integrate with technologies like Zoom and Teams and things like that?
Yeah, exactly. And of course, we already have NDI there, which is awesome. And so again, that's a very similar question I field all the time. And we've already done quite a bit of experimentation and have a number of customers leveraging NDI with Microsoft Teams, because they were really in the conferencing space. First ones really jump on that. In theory, the other ones are supposed to follow suit. We'll see when they get it done. But again, bridging those different technologies from more of the production space and the conferencing space and, you know, talking about the differences between streaming purely versus conferencing. These are different things, even though they get muddled. Yeah. And understanding where we need them in different ways is great. And then being able to leverage technology like NDI to cross over between them has been awesome. So for us in the future, you know, we're definitely looking forward to how other people add NDI. And we're just looking to make sure that, you know, new versions of NDI roll out fairly frequently. So we keep pace with that with our firmware updates and to make sure that that interconnectivity and that interop between cameras to software and everything in between, everything stays on the same page.
Yeah. Now, another part of the future that's kind of today is like social media. As an aside, you know, I gave Microsoft Teams like big props on my LinkedIn. I posted an article on new tech and LinkedIn, you know, NDI for Microsoft Teams. And I kind of like, ended, you know, when are the Zoom guys going to come out with this? And sure enough, a product manager from Zoom said, sooner than you think. Don't worry, we're on it. So everyone realizes that NDI is a very low cost, low overhead way of adding this IP networking, unlike trying to do, you know, the SMTP, which is gonna be, yeah, I understand the networks have to answer to a higher level on that, but NDI works, it works great. And the other thing I wanna add is, and you were there, you know, 1, 2, 3, the first three versions of NDI, we're figuring this stuff out. With 4 and 4.5, it's really become rock solid. The auto discovery that was a promise really works. I like to say, you know, in the early days, I used to call plug and play, plug and pray. And NDI auto discovery was like NDI IMEI discovery, but now it works great. And we find that if we add another NDI piece to our network, it lights up almost, you know, you gotta wait a few seconds, but you wait a few seconds and it just lights up everywhere like it's supposed to. It's really a technology that's far more cooked than it was even a year or two ago.
Oh, absolutely, I completely agree.
Now, also with the future, I mentioned social media a little bit. Do you think you guys will have things that will like add like Twitter or Facebook or LinkedIn more, you know, tightly integrated with these products, or maybe you could see like comments or other stuff like that, or how many likes you're getting?
I mean, it depends. We have to see where things go. I mean, it's certainly something that's very easy to do right now, leveraging a combination of external software packages with NDI technologies to bring that into your stream now. And down the road, you know, we'll have to see. You know, one of the advantages of something like a Perl is that it is essentially a closed system. It's not something that's running on Windows. And so that lends to it being very reliable, but it does make it a little difficult or a little slower sometimes to add some of these quick little things like that. So, you know, we're always looking at that. We have a ton of people every day. I'm fielding questions on feature requests and there's some great, great ones out there, including deeper integrations like that. Like you said, I think a lot of this, as we've seen over the past 7 and 8 months, there's a lot more things moving into the cloud. And I think that that's where we're gonna start to see a lot more of that stuff, partially because it's a lot easier to update and roll things out there and test things there. And so I think as cloud production really starts to kick off, something we're very excited about and have been experimenting with for months now, we'll see where that goes. And I think it's going to be really fascinating.
Well, I want to add, you're not experimenting with the cloud. You're actually using the cloud because you have another product, your LiveScript product, which, you know, actually uses artificial intelligence in the cloud to give you live transcriptions of your shows. And the funny thing is, you know, we've been talking about it is we've been told that if we have the transcript of our shows and our metadata and posted on our LinkedIn pages, you know, our SEO will be stronger. So we're actually thinking about putting LiveScript into our integrated workflow here so that we can actually have all that text to be able to, you know, pump up our SEO a little bit. Now, we're not quite there yet. We don't want to have it be the, you know, a 15-minute show is a lot of pages of text, you know, and we get that. So yeah. We got to figure out exactly how we're going to do that. But it's something we're going to look to do. And one of the things that you mentioned, the cloud, is, you know, not only are the Pearl and the Pearl 2 fantastic products, but I could also see them as gateway products into a bigger cloud infrastructure, whether it's a Epiphan cloud or someone else's cloud. They're a great way to plug devices in to get to the network, even if they no longer are used as switches, because the switching and the graphics and other stuff is happening, you know, on other people's computers in the cloud. So I think there's a lot of useful life for these products growing as the cloud happens, as they become your kind of endpoints or entry points to your cloud.
Yeah, contribution encoding is basically one of the big things in the future. And our soon-to-be-released Pearl Nano, the smallest in the Pearl family, is going to be a primary example of that perfect fit contribution encoder that's going to be able to, you know, send out SRT to a cloud ingestion system and get all your production done there. That's definitely the way the future is going. I can tell you we definitely have a very close eye on that, nothing I can give specifics about today, but there are things that are happening.
And the other thing we didn't mention is the Pearl and the Pearl Mini and the Pearl Nano will all have web-based interfaces for controlling them as well, which it's not NDI, but it kind of is, because it means you can do it from another device and it's all in the network, so I love that. Thank you, George, for being on the show. A great time, great stuff. I think people learned a lot about the Pearl 2 and NDI, and I think it's clear that you guys are here to stay for NDI. You know, when I had the folks at Panasonic, we called it all in. I think you guys are all in on NDI also, as long as the box has the power inside to support NDI. So thank you very much, George. I appreciate it. Now let's talk about our giveaway. That's right. NDI November, we're giving away an NDI Pro Huddle Cam. This is a 4K product that actually allows you to do EPTZ, so you can pick out HD regions of interest. We love it. We have it set up in our conference room. The link is here, and the link will be on our web pages to log in for that. And on Thursday's show, we're going to be giving away that unit, because Thursday, if we could bring this on, guys. This is our schedule that we have coming up for the next week, and they're going to pull it up into the screen and say, there you go. Wednesday, we have Will Waters coming on from NewTek, who's going to come on to talk about the NewTek product line and how they have NDI and what they're going with NDI. And then on the 12th, on Thursday, we've got Paul Richards from PTZ Optics coming in. He's going to tell us all about their NDI implementations, but also he's going to do that giveaway. So I want to say, George, thank you very much. Do we still have him? Can we bring him up? If we lost him, I get it. George, I just want to say thank you very much for coming on the show, and we can bring this slide up. This was Gary from Video Guys. Thanks for coming in, watching our NDI November shows. We've dedicated 2 weeks to NDI technology. We have two more shows to go. They're going to be loaded with great information, great guests. George, thank you so much. This is Gary from Video Guys reminding you, you know, like us, love us, share us on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube. You know the drill, folks. Help our social media, and we'll be able to help more people like you. Thank you for tuning in. We'll see you tomorrow. Remember, Tuesdays at 3 o'clock, Video Guys Live. Peace.
Video Guys is available Monday through Friday. Give us a call at 1-800-323-2325. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Instagram to stay connected with all of our updates. And you can like us on Facebook. Keep an eye out for our live videos, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.